Here I'm asked to solve this by elimination. I can eliminate the y's or the x's, doesn't really matter. I'm going to try to eliminate the x's by multiplying both sides of the top equation by negative 2. Okay, negative 2 times 3x is negative 6x. Negative 2 times negative 1 is plus 2y. And that's supposed to equal negative 2 times 7 is negative 14. Okay, now just rewrite the bottom equation right underneath it. I'm not going to modify it. And there's the equivalent system with the x's ready to eliminate. Now, when I add these two together, notice negative 6x plus 6x is 0, but also 2y minus 2y is 0, so we get 0 equals 0. Now, that looks like no solution, doesn't it? But in fact, that's a true statement. That's an identity. The math here is trying to tell me I have a dependent system. Dependent systems mean, basically the original, geometrically means the original two equations are actually the same line. Okay, so when you have infinitely many solutions, if infinitely many ordered pairs where they cross, we want to express our answers in set notation. All the ordered pairs that look like this are going to solve the original. Now we just have to figure out what is our particular point slope form. Okay, so we got to do some extra work. Let's go off to the side and look at one of these. Doesn't matter which one. Here I'm going to put this in point slope form. I'm going to solve for y by first subtracting 3x on both sides. Okay, leaves me with negative y equals negative 3x plus 7. Okay, and then dividing by negative 1. Or multiplying by negative 1, either way, you're left with y equals 3x minus 7. So our answer is here, infinitely many solutions in set notation, x comma 3x minus 7. This is a dependent system, and these are all the solutions, where x could be any real number.